With its preserved Georgian old town full of narrow streets or twittens and a rich fishing heritage, there's much more to Hastings than an historic battle. The town has undergone a recent resurgence, with a new generation of antiques dealers popping up alongside the veterans. So for Drew, this is an unmissable opportunity to get stuck into an untapped new resource. Starting with a vintage hardware store, seemingly from a bygone era, run by Alastair Hendy.
Hello. Oh, how are you doing,
Hello.
Drew?
Hi, nice to meet you.
What a place.
This is lovely.
It's amazing. So tell me, what's the ethos behind this then?
Well, we're a contemporary hardware store. We sell a lot of new range things like brushes and scissors and string. And then we've got a lot of vintage, but in the same line, all natural materials.
Right. Let's have a look at these. God, I just want literally everything in here. Alistair said this is a modern hardware shop and so much more. Yes, it's modern hardware and vintage and antique and uber cool furniture as well. I mean, it does literally tick every single box. I don't know what that is for, but I want it.
Cabinet broom, that one.
A cabinet broom?
Cleaning behind all your filthy cabinets.
I've never been that interested in cleaning. Coming in here, suddenly it struck a chord. I mean, things to clean your house that are beautiful.
Don't ask what that one's for.
Radiator.
Of course. I absolutely love. Look at that colourway. God, that's good. What are the feathers from? And don't say a bird tea.
I never said anything. A rather large bird, I'm sure you know, ostrich.
Yeah.
The feather dusters. Brilliant. I think they're wonderful.
Don't forget, I do need a feather duster.
Leaving the retro hardware downstairs, the curiosities continue upstairs, where Alistair displays his vintage interior design pieces.
Wow. God, you've had fun doing this, haven't you? This is superb.
Thanks very much.
Where do you get these from?
These are from the Dorchester.
Yeah.
I think they had sets and sets of them in the bedrooms.
They're a carved softwood, and then they've been painted and lacquered.
Love them. Absolutely. Just hit me straight away. Doesn't happen very often, and that's the feeling you want when you buy anything. It's like, I have to own those. I don't care if they're not for sale. I'm buying them. I've never seen any like it before. They're just the right size. They're just the right width. They're just the right height. They're just the right colour. They've just got it all.
This pair of turned, white lacquered lampstands were designed for and used in the famous Dorchester Hotel in London. Dating from the 1930s, once these English lamps had been rewired and safety tested, they could be worth around £500.
How much are they?
180 the pair.
Fine, sold. £180 the pair. Shake the man's hand. We'll have those all day long. They will see a very nice profit if and when I decide to sell them. Because right now, mentally, I can't let those go. They're just perfect. And I tell you what, the next person who buys these is going to go, they're from the Dorchester. Doesn't that sound good? And another beautiful room. Let me have a look at this little campaign mirror.
It is, yeah, and that's very reasonably priced.
Little campaign mirror there, completely untouched, really lovely. The mirror's very clean, but it still looks right. And a nice bit of age to it, actually.
This tabletop military campaign shaving mirror is made from oak and dates from around 1850. In completely original, unrestored condition, it could be worth around £200.
£95?
Yes. Nice campaign mirror, all folds away in its little box there. It's all intact.
I'll give you £80 for that.
Yeah, go on then.
Thanks. So, marvellous. £80 paid, no problem. Straight into the shop, £150, £180, no problem for that. Very nice little piece. We'll be back later for the stuff.
Yep.
With more than 20 antique and bric-a-brac shops in Hastings' old town alone, the boys hot-footed to the next.
Shops everywhere. Is that another shop?
Yeah, and there's another one there.
Second on the list is Goods Depot, run by American Jeff Zebel, a dealer since the 70s.
Ooh, this looks nice. Oh, yeah. How you doing, Drew?
All right.
How are you doing,
MC? Yes,
Jeff.
You all right?
Where do I start? This is wonderful. What a great place. What a wonderful little shop. This is like falling into a beautiful little boy's own manual. And it's that singular eye, which I really enjoy. I like this green bust over here.
Yeah.
Bronze boy's head sculpture, 360. Has it got any age to it?
It is. It's 1920. The sculptor died in 1920.
This patinated bronze bust of a young boy on a polished marble base is signed by French-Italian artist Gori. Born in Florence in 1895, Gori specialized in Art Deco figurative sculpture. Little more is known about the artist, who died in 1925. This example of his work could be worth around £1,000.
It's quite melancholy in its feel. Good color. They were widely faked and reproduced. I've not seen that one before. That's OK, we'll take a chance on it. So what's the best you can do on that little fella?
360, I can do for three.
Sure, yep. Great. We'll
OK, thank you.
Lovely. Nice little thing. Another thing I like was this dressing mirror, gentleman's outfitter's mirror. Oh, but it's got this wonderful japanned finish to it.
Crackle glaze or whatever you want to hear. Yeah.
It's a sort of shop, gent's outfitter's mirror. I love the form, love the colour, the condition's perfect. All of it, just a great thing.
This English tailor's dressing mirror with a cast iron base and chromed adjustable upstand dates from the 1950s. With its original mirror plate in a black timber frame, it could be worth around £700.
285, what can you do?
Okay, 285, 240.
240, yeah, I'll have it.
Okay, thank you.
Marvellous. We have really good luck with these. Any sort of dressing mirror whatsoever, we do really well with. The last one flew out and there was a waiting list, so that one will go.